Yes. Dude, that's so perfect. Diona is a character that I was really impressed with the community response waiting for her and looking for ways to use her, so I took some time to mess around with her kit and wanted to discuss further based on what I see and what others have commented in my first look video to give you an idea of how we should use her and best options available. Diona is our newest Lolly added to the game and the first we can obtain as a free-to-play friendly. I was lucky enough to get her on my fourth pull, and after summoning for Child, I was able to obtain 3 constellation increases for her. Now, consider subscribing for more information on characters, news, and factual reviews on Genshin Impact. It's a great time too because I also have another video I'm working on right now. I don't want to spoil it, but I think it'll help people understand the value of the current characters being offered. Now, let's talk about your goal with Diona in your comp. Your goal with her is to use her Hold E ability to create 5 icy paws that seek out targets, creating a shield based on the number of hits. If all of them hit at a base level of the skill, 1.8 seconds per claw, so 9 seconds. You then rotate her out for your main character, who should be kitted to use either a shield scaling attack weapon or use to counter cryo to be able to do some form of elemental reaction. I'll give you a hint though, the weapon's banner's 5-star is built on exactly the shield scaling attack percentage that I'm talking about, and that is for Ningguang. If you manage to go for the weapon for her, it gets a 5-stacking 4% attack percentage boost to attack on hit, but if you have a shield on her, it improves the shield by 20% and doubles the attack boost, raising the ceiling to 40% attack. And if you pair Ningguang with another earth element, so this is kind of going in the direction of Zhongli, you get an additional 15% attack boost when a shield is applied. So as you can see, that is kind of the direction the game is going. Since Ningguang doesn't create her own shield, that's where Diona comes into play to synergize. Now looking over some of the stats for Diona, she has an Ascension Init substat of cryo damage bonus. Her E ability, Shield's damage absorption is based on Diona's max HP. In her Ascension 4, her charge shot time is reduced by 60%, making her the fastest charge shot bow user once leveled. Now, in her Constellation 1, she's going to regenerate 15 energy out of the 80 energy required for her Q ability at the end of the skill. On her Constellation 6, if you manage to get her to that point, under 50% HP, she's going to have a 30% healing boost, and over 50% HP, she's going to have her Elemental Mastery plus 200. And she's a shield creator. I can see her being above 50% and a healer as well. I can see the Elemental Mastery playing the biggest factor here. Now, taking a look at the stat priority based on some of this information, I'm thinking energy recharge is a primary so that you can use her Q ability as much as possible, especially since it has a need of 80 energy in order to use. And then secondary to that, because she is based on cryo damage percentage and because of most of her skills creating them, cryo damage percentage makes the most sense to increase into second. And then third, I would say HP for shield scaling or attack depending on what your goals are, or even maybe even elemental mastery just to increase the elemental reaction ability with her. Typically though, she's gonna be the trigger for the elemental reaction rather than the person creating the reaction. So that's something to keep in mind. Taking a look at the weapons, I'm thinking energy recharge is needed to reduce the need for 80 costs for her Q ability and to spam hold E to reinstate the shields, as well as just being able to do cryo damage. The weapon that comes to mind is the sacrificial bow. It makes the most sense, and since her cat claws create the shield, your chance of proccing the reset are immediate and are not on a damage over time basis, such as a unit like Chi-Chi using it. You also have Stringless, which Stringless is always good, so you could use it on anyone to just improve damage. And then we also have Favonius Warbow. Now this could work since it regenerates 1 orb every 6 to 12 seconds, depending on how much you have it upgraded. Which if you use Aimshot, which her kit is built to decrease the time, so Aimshot is a more viable option for her. Critting is more controllable with a bow user, and then plus energy recharge is higher. You must also look at the cooldown timeframe after her Q ability is cast. If your energy recharge happens before then, it's a waste to improve that piece further, and makes more sense to go with the latter. Taking a look at the artifacts that would be best in slot for a character like her, I'm thinking Noblesse, Oblige, or Scholar. Noblesse for the attack buff for your entire team, since you're using her to kind of set up the rest of your team, and additional burst damage, and then Scholar to further improve the recharge if needed. I currently am running her on Scholar just because Noblesse isn't something I have grinded for yet. Comps that I'm thinking you can use Diona for right off the bat is a Klee Melt comp or a Diluc Melt comp. On Q, it reduces stamina and increases speed 10%, and creates an opposing element shield to protect the fire character. This makes more sense for Klee, just because she is a little bit squishier. Second one is Ningguang with Memory of Dust 5-star Catalyst. I can see this just breaking shit. The third is Noelle without having her C6 for unlimited shields. And then there is also a leak on the Unforged Claymore, which is supposed to boost attack by 100% while having a shield. That'll be more beneficial for an attack-based Claymore user that is being shielded by a support, rather than one that, like Noelle, has a defense scaling for her attack. There will also most likely be future builds depending on the mechanics of the game, and I'm sure there are others currently, so comment below what rotation you could see her being beneficial in. So to recap, Diana is very different than what we've seen, and I urge you to be careful on passing up on her as a unit because of her kit not making sense right now. I did the same a bit, not gonna lie, but I think if you have Ningguang or Noelle, who can scale off shields, and even with the direction of Zhongli or even Xiao later, if he is a Dark Knight style HP drain DPS type unit, shields could save them and improve DPS depending on the future mechanics and how weapons are built. So I'd say at least grab her once so you have her, because you never know, and the chances are pretty good with the raid ups to get the 4-star at least once for the mass majority. I've seen many talk about how they got Child instead, which he is a monster that people are sleeping on, and I already know people are going to figure it out for themselves and realize how broken his passive is with certain comps. But as for now, Diana is a great support unit that can help you proc Superconduct, Frozen, or Melt, and can protect and heal the main character DPS, helping you lean into your weaker DPS units. Please comment below your findings and anything you have to add. I'd love to thank all of you in my original video for the theory crafting, the likes, the love. I appreciate all of you so much. Thank you very much. It's insane to see how an unedited video got so much loves and comments, so I'll definitely upload unedited new information that I think will benefit the community and make more informational guides out there and explain the data supporting it. Good luck with your summons, and I will see you in the next one.